The Veeam Agent for Microsoft Windows is a very powerful way to back up physical systems, such as a physical server or even workstation devices, but also systems on alternate hypervisors. In a previous video, I showed how easy it was to deploy the Veeam Agent for Microsoft Windows on a single system, but if you want to talk about scale, you need to see a protection group. So let's jump into a quick video where I show you how to deploy the Veeam Agent for Microsoft Windows via a protection group. So what we're looking at here is the inventory section of Veeam Backup and Replication, which is part of Veeam Data Platform. Inside of here, I already have a few protection groups created. I want to make a new one that's going to deploy the Veeam Agent for Windows to several systems within my environment. So I highly recommend self-descriptive names. Now, this is an example that I'm doing for you on this YouTube channel. So if you want to see other YouTube stuff, let us know. But let's call this Deploy the Veeam Agent for Microsoft Windows via AD, Active Directory. And we'll have just a few options to select. Now, the type of protection group, this has expanded over the years and you'll probably see more from us. We can go with individual computers, which is just a list. We can also go with Active Directory objects that I'm going to use in organizational unit. It's a great way to scale it. You can also pull in a CSV file. We also have the way of catching all agents that have come in on their own pre-installed, or we can go into the cloud. You have a lot of options to protect with the agent. Now I'm going to browse this Active Directory environment here, and I'm going to find the organizational unit where I have these several systems that I want to protect. So what you do is you'll browse through your Active Directory domain structure, and I have this OU called Physical Systems. This is where I've put the computer accounts for the systems I want to protect with the Veeam Agent for Microsoft Windows, and I want to automatically deploy it to that OU, and you can see that I have six systems in there. So when I go to the next option, I have some exclusions. I could exclude virtual machines, maybe if I mix physical and virtual in that environment, that might change how I protect. I also can exclude computer accounts that haven't been on for over 30 days, or I can browse Active Directory and find explicit things that I want to skip. This is an important one though, the master account. This is going to be the account that has the permission to deploy the Veeam Agent. So I'm using a service account for this one. You don't want to use individual user accounts. And you can also get into granular configurations and also test it before you deploy. Now, there's a couple of options on the protection group creation. The first of all is around the installation of the change block tracking driver. This is a really cool set of technology that Veeam has made for incremental backups on physical systems. It may require a reboot, so keep that in mind on your deployment. I highly recommend doing both the change block tracking driver and the automatic reboot. And if you also want, you can deploy enterprise application plugins for key database systems as well. Now, finally, I want to highlight that the rescan is done at 9 o'clock p.m. Those of you familiar with Veeam know that backup jobs default to 10 o'clock p.m. So this is a great way to deploy the agent right before the backup window starts. Now, what happens here is we're going to look at that organizational unit and do a scan once this protection group is made. So let's go ahead and do that right now. And that's a task called discovery. Discovery is when that organizational unit, in this example, is queried to say, what is in that OU? And we should get these six systems. These six systems now will automatically get the Veeam Agent for Windows deployed to them and the change block tracking driver installed, and if a reboot is needed, that will happen. Now in my other videos, I'm going to also show you how to create a backup job. The discovery is just deploying it, which is what's happening right here. But what about actually doing the backup? Be sure to watch the next video in my series where I talk about making a backup job of this protection group all at once. And you'll also want to think about downloading a trial of the Veeam Data Platform, because all of this capability is included in a fully functioning trial. What you can see right here is concurrently on all six of the systems, the agent is being deployed, installed, and in this case, a reboot is needed. And just like that, I have created a protection group and automatically deployed the Veeam agent to several systems all at once. And what I can look at now is that they have the agent installed, but I have not ever taken a backup. You'll see that last agent backup equals never. Stay tuned to my next video where you can see how easy it is to protect multiple systems at once. So just like that, it's really easy to deploy the Veeam Agent for Microsoft Windows. In fact, I think that's definitely the way to do it. Whether you want to deploy to an organizational unit or those lists or other different constructs, it's very easy to do with Veeam. Be sure to subscribe to our YouTube channel. Drop a comment, drop a like. Let us know what videos you want. We look at this and we can craft our next videos based on what you want. So go on over to Veeam.com and download a trial today.